Hello, bloomers and friends. Rev Kev coming to you from amidst some of the spring flowers in Palm Springs. I hope you can make them out in the background there over my shoulder. It has been a phenomenal several days in all of our lives as world events have been huge in the way in which we are called to digest them. And even local events have been important here in Palm Springs. We know about world events with conflict and the kinds of things that have gone on regarding Osama bin Laden and his capture and killing. We know that there are many people who have a variety of opinions about the results of that. Most people have a sense of relief. There's an awful lot of people that are wondering how we as Christians respond when we are people who are called to love our enemies and to care for those who persecute us. It is hard to sort through some of these feelings that we have in a time when it feels like a great relief has been lifted, but the methods that are done to do that are methods of violence and killing. These are things that we have to reconcile in some way and know that even what happens now when hard decisions are made, we can look to a future, hoping that in the future those are not the same kinds of decisions we will have to make ourselves. I hope that doesn't sound too wishy-washy on my part. What I think it is I'm still trying to figure some of that out myself. I hear the paraphrase of the proverb that says that we are not to rejoice when an enemy falls. I hear also the Dalai Lama talk about, well, when something is so evil, it is important to do what you can to rid the world of the greatest evils. So these kinds of conflicts are all brought into mind when we bring our faith together and are in faith considering these kinds of issues. I know that here locally, we had some rejoicing last night. The city council voted 5-0 to support a marriage resolution, a marriage equality resolution. And this is after 2 weeks ago when the resolution first came up, the city council voted 3-1-1. One council member abstained and one opposed it. I truly think that the voices of citizens speaking out about the realities of marriage inequality and the injustice that is involved in that, and even the fact of one man who lost his partner, a partner of decades, about 5 months ago, who now is losing his home because he cannot get the Social Security adjustment that people in that other married couples get. This truly had an effect. I was one of the people who spoke on behalf of our church, and I said I'm the United Church of Christ pastor in Palm Springs. I was the only person of faith speaking. And it wasn't because invitations didn't go out to many others, even those who are considered liberal. I think for some people, they are not able to reconcile the decisions in their minds yet, as clearly as I've been able to from my own personal experience, as well as what I believe our faith calls us to in justice. So these are big days, and as people of faith, we are, I think, called to have thoughts and to consider things like this when there are major events in the world and major decisions are made both globally and locally. I hope that as a community we know that we do this together, and that's a part of what we're doing as we are living out our motto that God wants us to think for ourselves and live for others. So until the next time I see you, hopefully it's this Sunday, I hope that you will keep us in your prayers. We love you. We miss those who have already left, and we look forward to seeing you soon. Bye-bye.
Bless the beast and the children. Give them shelter from a storm. Keep them safe, keep them warm. The children.